In this question, we're given a polynomial function and asked to provide a variety of information. We first want to write the polynomial function in descending order, which means you want to order the terms from highest degree to lowest degree. So looking at all the terms in this polynomial function, notice how this term here has the highest degree, so it's going to be the first term in descending order. The next highest degree is degree 3, so this term would be second. The next highest degree is degree 2, this would be the third term. This has degree 1, this is the fourth term. And the constant term has degree 0, so it's going to be the fifth term. So in descending order, we would have f of x equals negative 3x to the sixth plus 4x cubed minus 2x squared plus 7x and minus 3. Next, we're asked for the degree of the polynomial function. The degree of the polynomial function is the degree of the term with the highest degree. So if we look at the polynomial function in descending order, the degree of the polynomial will be the degree of this first term, which is 6. So the degree of the polynomial is 6. If it's not in descending order, of course we'd have to look for the term that has the highest degree. The leading coefficient is the coefficient of the term with the highest degree. Again, if it's in descending order, we can easily see the leading coefficient is going to be negative 3. The reason it's called the leading coefficient is because most of the time we do want to give polynomial functions in descending order, so negative 3 would be the first or leading coefficient. Now the maximum number of real zeros would be the same as the maximum number of x-intercepts or horizontal intercepts, and this is equal to the degree of the polynomial function. So in this case, the maximum number of real zeros would be 6. And then the maximum number of turns in a polynomial function is equal to the degree minus 1. In this case, 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. So the most number of turns this polynomial function could have would be 5.